Respiratory system of cockroach. Respiratory system of cockroach. Generally here the cockroach does not contain any respiratory pigment in the blood. So blood is colorless fluid. So that's why it does not contain any respiratory pigment. Due to the absence of respiratory pigment, it cannot transport the oxygen to the various parts of the body. And after utilization of oxygen, that will be converted to carbon dioxide. That carbon dioxide has to be released outside by the respiratory system, but here that process is absent. So for the purpose of transportation of oxygen and releasing of carbon dioxide, in cockroach a specific tracheal trunks will be formed. So here the tracheal system of cockroach included with various structures. So here the tracheal trunks or tracheal system of cockroach is composed with spiracles, trachea and tracheoles. So these are the three structures present in the respiratory system of cockroach. So let us see what are spiracles, or they are also known as stigmata. So in cockroach there are 10 pairs of spiracles are present. So where they are present, you see, first two pairs are located in the thorax region and the remaining 8 pairs are located in the abdominal region. So these are the 10 pairs we can identify in the respiratory system of cockroach. So total 10 pairs of spiracles, they are also known as stigmata. And you see, if you see the thorax is divided into 3 parts. Prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax will be present. But prothorax does not contain any specific spiracles or stigmata. And the first pair of 2 pairs are located in the mesothorax region and the second pair is located in the metathorax region. So these are the 2 pairs located in the thorax region. Hence that spiracles are also known as thoracic spiracles. They are located in the thorax region. And you see that what are the structures are present in the spiracle. If you open this spiracle, we can identify some specific structures. So generally every spiracle opens are covered with this chitinous ring. That chitinous ring is also known as peritree. Peri means around, tree means small hole. Around the hole that chitinous ring is present, hence that character is also known as peritree or chitinous ring. So inside of that inner wall of that is spiracle is lined by hair like projections. That hair like projections are also known as here trichomes. So trichomes generally prevents the dust particles whenever the oxygen passes into the atrium of the spiracle. So there we can identify that trichome like structures and which prevents the dust particles. And that cavity is there inside the spiracle. That cavity is known as here atrium. So these are the structures we can identify in the each spiracle. Next, see that spiracles also exhibit 2 specific functions, that is here polyneuristic condition and holoneuristic condition. So what is polyneuristic condition and what is holoneuristic condition? Here polyneuristic condition, nothing but many spiracles will be present. Poly means many. So many spiracles are located in the respiratory system of cockroach. So that's why that condition is known as polyneuristic condition. And also exhibits holoneuristic condition. Holo means all spiracles. Holo means complete here. So completely all the spiracles participate in the respiration process. So during the taking of oxygen, thoracic spiracles kept opened, and whereas the releasing of carbon dioxide, so then the thoracic spiracles kept closed and abdominal spiracles kept opened. So that's why during the respiration, taking of oxygen and releasing of carbon dioxide, so both the spiracles will be participated. Hence that condition is known as holoneuristic condition. So these are the characters we can identify in the spiracles or stigmata of cockroach respiratory system. And next, second character, trachea. So body which is composed by so many tracheal trunks. So tracheal trunks here, they are of basically 2 types: cephalic tracheal trunks and that is longitudinal tracheal trunks. So cephalic tracheal trunk generally present in the head region, that is cephalon, nothing but head. So cephalic tracheal trunks will be divided into again 2 types. So dorsally arranged cephalic trunks and ventrally arranged cephalic trunks. So there are some sub branches also will be present. They will be expanded with the head region. So that is called as dorsal cephalic trunk and ventral cephalic trunk. And if you come to the abdominal region, so first 8 pairs, that is abdominal spiracles, will be present, and each spiracle which opens into the cavity, I said, that is atrium. So atrium opens into the tracheal trunks. So here tracheal trunks arranged in the form of longitudinal manner from the anterior end to the posterior end of abdominal region. So that's why they are called as longitudinal tracheal trunks. Here they are of 3 types. So longitudinally arranged tracheal trunks are 3 types here: laterally arranged longitudinal trunks, dorsally arranged longitudinal trunks, and ventrally arranged longitudinal trunks. So these are the 3 tracheal trunks. We can identify the abdominal regions from the anterior end to the posterior end. And if you see that each trachea, see that all the tracheal trunks are interconnected by specific connections are there here. These are the connections which connects the one another. So that connections are known as here commissural trachea. So commissural trachea are the interconnecting links between the all the tracheal longitudinal trunks. So here that character we can identify between the longitudinal tracheal trunks. And if you open that trachea, so trachea basically composed by 3 layers: outermost layer, middle layer, and inner layer. So outermost layer of the trachea is known as basement membrane, and middle layer of the trachea is known as epithelium, and inner layer is known as intima. So 3 layers will be present in the each trachea: outer layer, middle layer, and inner layer. So outer layer is called as basement membrane, and middle layer is known as epithelium, and inner layer is known as intima. So between the 2 intima layers, spiral thickenings will be present, which are composed by the chitin material. So that structures are known as here tinidia. So tinidia are the structures here prevents the collapsing of trachea whenever it is whenever the oxygen or carbon dioxide passes through these particular structures. To prevent the collapsing of trachea, here tinidia structures will be formed between the 2 intima layers, inner layers. And if you go to the tracheoles, so trachea which opens into the tracheoles are the extensions of trachea. So tracheoles which are composed by the trochanin protein. And what is the difference between the trachea and tracheoles here? So tracheoles does not contain intima layer. Only 2 layers will be present: outer basement layer and middle epithelium, that is also here it is known as inner layer, that is epithelium layer. But here inner intima is absent. If they are absent, tinidia also absent. But how that prevents the collapsing of tracheoles here? So tracheoles generally filled with tracheolar fluid. So whenever that fluid is sufficiently present inside the tracheoles will be prevented from the collapsing of tracheoles. But whenever the fluid is utilized by the cockroach, whenever it is active, then that will be using of what cockroach. So that is here whenever the fluid is present, that will be prevented of collapsing of tracheoles. And whereas that whenever the cockroach is active, that utilize the fluid. So generally that fluid which is composed by and also includes mitochondria.